I'm always grateful to be a Muslim. I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving me the shahadatain, for allowing me to worship him, fi sabilillah, in his cause. It's a mercy from Allah to be a Muslim. And we read the Quran, we read Rahman, Rahim, Rahman, Rahim. Allah is most merciful, but he's also gracious. Rahman precedes Rahim when you read the Quran. You ever thought about why? Why is it Rahim and Rahman first? Rahman and Rahim is all through the Quran. Every surah, except ninth surah. Repentance, Tawbah. That's the only one that doesn't start with Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. And there's a reason for that. We should question that. The ninth surah is Tawbah, repentance. Repentance. And we all need that. The whole humanity needs that. But it doesn't start with Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Rahman is graciousness. Rahman is the one who created you in the wombs of your ummi, your mama. Peace be upon our mamas. So Rahman is first. Rahman is gracious. Allah is a giver. He's the supreme giver. Nobody gives compared to what Allah gives. What humanity gives is a drop in the ocean compared to what Allah gives. So he's Rahman. In fact, he's not El Rahman, he's Ar-Rahman. The Ra is the sun letter in Arabic. That's why you don't say Al, you say Ar, Ar. The Ra is sun letter, moon letter, sun letters in Arabic. So Ra is a sun letter. So we say Ar-Rahman, Ar-Rahim. Praise be to Allah. Allah is most merciful. He's most gracious. He's the one that gave us everything that you have that is halal, wa-tayyabun, good and permissible. Allah gave that to you. That's Rahman. So Allah, everything that we have that's good is from Allah. That's the Rahman. That's what we talk about. That's what you're talking about. Ar-Rahman. And then behind that comes Rahim. Mercy. Not human mercy, divine mercy. There's a big difference. Allah can forgive you for anything that you've done. In fact, Allah said in the Quran, the only thing he won't forgive is what? Shirk. That's the only thing. He won't forgive you for shirk. But anything else, he will forgive you for. That's a merciful God. Allahu Akbar. Who can do that except Allah? So whatever we have done that we're ashamed of, and I did some stuff back in the day that I'm trying to forget. Real world, I'm real. And you got some stuff you want to forget too. Well, see, that's where the Rahim comes in. See, Allah forgives you. He forgives you. I told you, I used to work in the prison, Hudson County Correctional Center, and I had everything come up in my office. Murder, homicide, they tell me everything, you know. And I sit there and listen to the brothers, you know. One brother came in and told me, Brother Imam, when I was on the street, I took somebody's life. That's what the brother told me. What are you going to say? The brother wants to vent. We all have to vent. That was bothering his subconscious, his conscious mind. You see? And I told him the same thing I'm telling you. That's where Rahim comes in. Mercy. Not human mercy, divine mercy. So whatever you've done that you're ashamed of that was haram and you know it's haram, Allah will forgive you if you're sincere. And we can prove this. I'm not just talking this. We can prove this in the Quran. I can back this up with Quran. Let me ask you a question. Musa alayhi salam. Didn't Moses kill a man in Egypt? He did. It's in the Quran. He took another person's life. It's in the Quran. And where is Moses now? He's in Jannah. In fact, he's on the sixth level, right under Abraham, alayhi salam. So that's the Rahim. That's the point I'm trying to get you to see. So even now, here's a prophet that took somebody's life. But Allah forgave him because Allah is Rahman Rahim. He's the most merciful God. He's the creator. He loves us. As-salamu alaykum. Now today, alhamdulillah, we want to jump right to this. Alhamdulillah. We thank Allah for giving us Yawm al-Jum'ah. Allah says here in the 17th surah of the Quran, and he says it very beautifully and right to the point, and we should read the Quran regularly. The Quran is the answer to all of our problems, brothers and sisters, believe me. God's word is the answer to everything. The 17th surah of the Quran is Bani Israel. Bani Israel. In fact, I just finished talking about Moses. Moses was sent to Bani Israel. Alhamdulillah, I didn't know that. So Allah says here in the 82nd ayah, He says, Bismillahi Rahman Rahim, wa nuzalahu min Qur'ani huwa shifa umma rahmatil mu'minin wa la yadihuna zalimin illa khasara. Allahu Akbar. Allah says here in the 82nd verse, He says, surely we have sent down stage by stage in this Quran that which is a healing. A healing. I want you to hear this. A healing. And rahmatil. We just finished talking about it. And a mercy. To those who believe, to the unjust, it causes nothing but loss after loss. Now listen to what Allah says here. He's telling us we have sent down stage by stage. That means it didn't come all at once. We know the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam received the Quran. It took 23 years before the Quran was revealed to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. 23 years. The Prophet was 40 years old when he got the Quran. Let's do a little math up in here. So he died at 63. These are facts. So that means he died at 63. He got it at 40 years old. 23 years. The Prophet got the Quran, and he was out of here. Allah took him. That's a sign. His whole life was to deliver the Quran. That's it. The Prophet lived to be 63 years old. In fact, the history says he died on Monday. Do your research. Check it out. But the Prophet, the whole point of the Prophet's life was to receive the Quran, to enact the Quran, to live the Quran as an example to all humanity. That was his purpose. And then Allah took him and put him in Jannah. Okay? So Allah says, we have sent it down, we have sent it down, nazalu min Quran, we have sent it down stage by stage. It descended slowly. It came down slowly. Allah reveals His truth to us slowly. We couldn't take it all at one time. Stage by stage. It was sent down, the Quran, that which is a shifa. Shifa means a healing. Okay? It's a healing. And I'm not talking about your physical body. I'm talking about your heart and your mind, your soul. This ain't about biology up in here today. I'm talking about your soul. Okay? Allah's not interested in your body. He's interested in your soul. Real clear. Okay? Because that's what's going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not our body. Not how many biceps I got. Not I'm 6'9", weigh 450. He don't care about that. He's interested in your soul, your nafsikal. The most valuable commodity that we have as Muslims right now is our soul. Okay? And in your soul is connected to your intellect. Some people have been separating this. No, your intellect is part of your soul. Your heart is part of your soul. The whole entity is human. That's what makes you a human being. That's your human entity. Your mind connected to your heart. Okay? So that's what's going back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? So Allah is telling us that I'm interested in what you did, Rahman, while you was here. That's all. I'm not interested in your articulation. Not what you said. If what you said doesn't correspond to what you do, then you're a liar. Okay? The Prophet Muhammad lived 63 years. 23 years was that of example of the Quran. He was a human example to show you, not only am I going to give you the word of God, but I'm going to show you how to use it. That's Rahim. I'll go right back to Rahim again. That's mercy. So Allah didn't just give us words, kalimah. He didn't just give us verbal articulation. No, He gave you an example of how to treat your woman, or how to take care of your children. Or how to respect your mother. Or how to respect your neighbor. Or how to be decent. He gave you a human example so you can execute it. You can't say I didn't understand because Muhammad executed it perfectly. Right? So Allah is saying that we have sent down stage by stage in the Quran that which is a healing and rahmatil, and a mercy. So it's a healing. It's a healing to whatever is bothering you, brother, sister. The Quran will heal your spiritual intellect. It will heal, it will repair your heart that's been damaged by shaitan. It is the natural, organic word of God. The Quran is organic words. Organic. Organic means it's whole. It hasn't been processed like food that we eat. This is whole grain. You know, when you eat food, you look for whole grain. You don't look for processed. The Quran is whole. Okay? So this is whole mental consumption. We eat the Quran just like you eat your food. You eat whole food. You go to Whole Foods to buy Whole Foods. Well, the Quran is whole Quranic mental spiritual nutrients to your system. Yeah. What Allah says is organic. And in the word organic is the word organ. Just don't recite words. Look at words. Look into words. Dissect words. There's a meaning in every word that you're not seeing. It's organ. You have your body is made up of what? Organs. So the Quran is a healing, is a shifa to every organ in your system. We have set down stage by stage in the Quran that which is a healing and a rahmatil and a mercy to those who believe. To those who believe. The Quran is a mercy to those, it's a healing for those who believe, but to those who don't believe, it causes nothing but fire. Narun. Yes. So if you don't believe, the Quran can either take you to heaven or it can take you to hell. It's your call. It's your call. So Allah says, He says to us, if we are to become productive human beings following the Quran and the Sunnah of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then we are obligated to focus our efforts to learning the Quran in its revealed language and then teach it. Allahu Akbar. That's what Allah says. If we all become productive human beings, you notice it said productive. In order to be productive, you have to be doing something that will benefit humanity. Okay? So Allah is showing us that the Quran is the answer to our problems. It was the answer to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Look what the Quran did to Mecca, 570. Go back, put your mind back to 570. The Prophet was born in 570, year 570. Look what was going on during that time. People getting high. They still getting high up here, I think. Raping women. They still raping women out here, I think. Disabusing women. Abusing women. Stealing. I think they still doing that. Stick up still going on. So the same condition that exists in 570 during the time of Prophet Muhammad is right here in 2017. Same day. It's like a blink. The same thing is going on. Gangs. Prophet Muhammad had gangs. He was from the Carter tribe. You couldn't come up in Mina. You couldn't come over in Medina. Same thing in Newark. Same thing in Jersey City. Same thing in Elizabeth. You can't come over here. Can't come over here. You come over here, you got a problem. You got a same thing. It's the same scenario that happened 570, 1400 years ago. Exact same thing. And what happened? Allah sent the Quran. As what? A shifa, rahmatil. As a healing and a mercy. So if it worked for Prophet Muhammad, it'll work right here in Elizabeth. Or New York. Or JC. Or Newark. Or Patterson. Or Camden. It'll work anywhere. Because Allah already proved it through Prophet Muhammad. So we have the formula. We have a natural, organic formula to heal you. It's the Quran. It's the words in the Quran. Allah's words is what is the healing process, brothers and sisters. That's what does it. It's the Quran. It's not the Imam or the Sheikh or whoever's talking. It's not about him. It's about what the Quran says. So I appeal to your intellect. Don't wait for Ramadan to step up here next month, in May 27th. Don't wait. Read the Quran now. Because what's being done is that you're benefiting your nafsikun, your intellect, and your mind, and your heart. Let us think about this while we make this short dua. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina adhaban nar. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin kama salatta ala Ibrahim wa ala ali Ibrahim. Allahumma barik ala Muhammadin wa ala ali Muhammadin كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين أنك حميد مجيد. الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله. O Allah, exalt Muhammad and the followers of Muhammad, as thou did exalt Abraham and the followers of Abraham. O Allah, bless Muhammad and the followers of Muhammad, as thou did bless Abraham and the followers of Abraham. In all the world, surely you are praised and magnified. Amen. Allahu Akbar. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, truly, in the body is a morsel of flesh, which if it is whole, we come right back to whole again, and sound. All the body is whole and sound. But if it be diseased and corrupt, then all of the disease will be in the system. Truly, this is the heart. Okay? We're talking about organs. There's something in the center of your chest right now called the Quran says, kubluhum. That's the Arabic, or sudur. But we say heart. We all have one. That is the most important organ in your whole system. And the proof of that is that when a person has a stroke, the heart pumps blood up to your brain so you can think. That's how you're able to think. If the heart doesn't pump blood up to your brain, you have a stroke, you die. It's real simple. This is science, and you can check this for yourself. So the heart, the prophet said that if the heart is corrupt, the whole system is corrupt. All the organs are corrupt. That's how important your heart is. So we should consume foods, organic, wholesome foods that nurture our heart physically. We should stay away from this fried stuff. Okay? We should be eating organic whole foods to protect our heart physically. Drink more water. So Allah says, truly, it is the body is a morsel of flesh, which is the heart. Say, O Muhammad, to mankind who is an enemy, whoever is an enemy to Jibril, for he is he who have revealed this scripture to thy heart by Allah's lead, confirming that which was revealed before it, and a guidance and glad tidings to believer. Where did Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam receive the Quran? On the heart. We go right back to the heart again. Not the brain. It's not about your intellect. If your intellect is not in accord with your heart, you spaced. I don't care how many degrees you got back up in here. Don't matter. Will then they not meditate on the Quran? Or are their locks on their hearts? He have written faith upon their hearts and have strengthened them with a spirit, ruhi, from him. And he will bring them into gardens underneath which rivers flow. Allahu Akbar. So this religion is all about your heart. Your life is really about your heart. And if you look at the word heart, at the prefix is he, H-E. And A-R-T means he designed it, art. So the word heart in its English phonetics points to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He, art, what is art? Art is something that you design. So he designed your heart. He designed you. He designed all humanity. That's your heart. Your heart purifies your system. That's why it's so important. We have to take care of our hearts physically, and whatever we do that is haram is an impurity to your heart. That's how you kill your heart. If you stick up banks and you hurt people, then you're putting spiritual daggers into your heart. That's a disease. Allahu Akbar. No calamity befalleth save by Allah's leave. And whoever believes in Allah, he guides his heart. And Allah is knower of all things. So it's about your heart. Your heart is guiding you. Your heart tells your brain what to do. Then you do it. Your heart will say, don't do that, Rahman. Don't take that. I know it's quick cash. But the heart will say, Rahman, there's a consequence coming. No, when that happens, what are you supposed to say? A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. I seek refuge with Allah from shaitan. That's how you handle temptation. Allahu Akbar. When he came into his Lord with a whole heart, Allah will not take you to task for that which is unintentional in your oaths. But he will take you to task for that which is in your hearts. Allah is forgiving. Al-Ghafur and Rahim. Here we go. Rahim. Right back again. Ghafur, Rahim. Al-Ghafur, Al-Rahim. We write back the mercy. We started with mercy. Okay? So if you do something that's haram, but it wasn't in your heart to do that, Allah will forgive you. It's right here in the Quran. Didn't Moses kill a man in Egypt? I just talked about that. He took a life. He's still in paradise. Still in paradise. That's rahim. That's mercy. So whatever we have done that is haram, I repeat, Allah is Rahman Rahim. He is Rahman Rahim. He is Rahman Rahim. We have to go to Allah with sincerity. That's all he wants, is sincerity. And he will not only forgive you, but he'll make you forget the deed that was haram. Allah does that. He'll take it from your memory banks. It won't even be there no more. Yeah. Allah has the power to do that. He can make you forget what's bothering you. That's Rahim. Allah ordained this only as a message of good cheer to you, and that thereby your hearts, we write back to your hearts, might be at rest. Victory cometh only from Allah and from Al-Aziz Hakim. Al-Aziz Hakim, from the wise. Allah is Al-Aziz, and he's also Al-Hakim. There's no wisdom outside of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allahu Akbar. Our Lord, cause not our hearts to stray after thou hast guided us, and bestow upon us rahim, mercy, from thy presence. For thou art the bestower of goodness. Allahu Akbar. So all of this today is talking about the most precious organ in your system, that is your heart. So I urge you, I love you, this is my family, this is my community. I love this community. When I go out, I want to go out right here in this community, Allahu Akbar, because we're all going out anyway. So it's important that we share with each other what is halal wa tayyabun, what is good that works. That's how this community grows and solidifies. That's what we need to do. We have to share the good. Everybody in here has something that the other person that you're sitting next to does not have. I don't care who you are. There's brothers out here no more than I know. That's good. And Allah says that the Muslim community should be like a solid brick wall. I don't know if you ever read. It's in the Quran. No hadith in the Quran. That blew my mind. So that means that if a brother out here knows something that I need, you should share that with me. Because I'm going to give you what I got. And if you do that, after a while, we get solidified. Nobody comes up in here. There's no room for shaitan. Because I got your back, you got my back. In fact, the word khalifa means to lead from the rear. I don't know if you know that. No, not the front. The imam's up front. Imam to be means to be up front. But the khalifa means one who leads from the rear. Women are khalifas. Let me throw this up here. Yes. Anytime your woman has your back, she's your khalifa. When you step with your wife and she's watching your back, she's a khalifa. Allahu Akbar. So we have to share that which is good with each other. If we do that, Allah will bless the whole. The Prophet said, he says, you will not become a believer until you want for yourself what you want for your brothers and sisters. That's what the Prophet said. So think about that the rest of your day. In my heart, do I really want to share with Kabir or Hakim or Salam? Do I really want them to have what I have? Oh yeah. That's the truth talking. We have to ask ourselves those questions. Or do I want to be above them? That's a powerful question, what the Prophet said. Because he says, you're truly not believers. Listen to the language now. He didn't say Muslim. He said, you're truly not believers until you want for yourself what you want for your brothers and sisters. That's powerful. And when we can ask ourselves that honestly and get a true answer, your answer might be no. I'm just being real. And your answer might be yes. I'm just being real. But you have to ask yourself that question. Because when you do that, then you're going to purify your heart. You purify your intentions. The Shifa, I just talked about it, first part of the Jummah. The Shifa, the healing process can begin. See? Healing can't begin until truth comes out. So you have to be truthful with yourself. When you step up in that mirror and you look in that mirror and you're getting yourself ready, you have to really look at yourself. Not just look at your hair and your shoes, your gaiters and all that. No, look at your soul. Do I really want for my brothers and sisters what I have for myself? Or do I want to be above them? Then you will become Ummat al-Wahidan. That's what the prophet said. Prophet Muhammad was a wise man. Allahu Akbar. He was a very wise man. So I want you to think about your heart. Think about you. Think about Allah. Purify your heart, because your heart is part of your soul. And your heart rules your brain 24/7. Because whatever is in your heart will certainly go up to your brain. No doubt about it. Also, improve your diet. Protect your heart. Eat foods that purify your heart, that shifa, that heals your heart. Because if we can heal your heart, then your thinking is going to be correct. As-salamu alaykum. You come.
Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, hayya ala salah, hayya ala falah, faqamati salah, faqamati salah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, la ilaha illallah.
La ilaha illallah, Muhammadan Rasulullah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.